You may not realize that as a taxpayer, you're also footing the bill for utilities at the governor's mansions. And the price tag for those bills may surprise you. Gina Mangieri is always investigating and breaks down the costs. Gina?
Joe, the utility bills for the two homes taxpayers maintain are just the start of the costs. There's hundreds of thousands in other maintenance and staffing, and the total budget of the executive compound isn't even tallied easily by the state itself.
Across the street from the Capitol sits Hawaii's first governor's residence, originally built for Queen Liliuokalani in the mid-1800s, and behind it, Halekia'aina. That's the second 21st century addition to the compound. Governor Cayetano and his wife spearheaded building it to leave Washington Place as an historic venue. Since then, Governor Lingle lived in the new home, so did Governor Abercrombie, and now Governor Ige and his family are unpacking there too. The lawns are manicured and watered, and the facilities kept prim and proper. There's air conditioning, surround security. They'll even leave a light on for you in the middle of the day, ticking away at the meters that run up quite a tab for taxpayers. $5,000 a month in electric. Hundreds for multiple phone landlines.
Some people might say, gee, why are you making a big deal about this? You know, we're talking about a $25 billion operating budget. But to the people that are paying it, it's significant. And it means that they're going to have to do without certain things to maintain this standard of living or these buildings.
Not many can afford a standard of living at $500 a month for cable and internet, but taxpayers buy it for the governor.
Does it surprise you when you see that, you know, a cable bill that's double, an electric bill that's way higher than what you or I might pay?
Well, I mean, there's more moving parts in here, too. I mean, more phone lines, more this or that. You're talking about two buildings.
Two buildings for which utilities are only the beginning. In recent years, Washington Place got an $844,000 renovation, tens of thousands in landscaping alone, a big recarpet job and scrub down at the newer residence between recent occupants.
I don't think it's one individual thing other than cleaning the showers for $4,000. It seems a little excessive. But look, here I am, I'm Joe homeowner, and I'm looking through my own bills every month I've got to pay, and then I see these are, you know, like five times more, and I'm already complaining about, you know, the extent of mine.
The full extent is not readily known. I searched purchasing notices one by one, but the day-in, day-out price of everything, from housekeepers to security to repair and maintenance and any anticipated capital costs, no one in government has a bead on what they think they'll have to spend every year. Over months of asking for the various bills and weeks trying to get the number out of the executive budget, the state is still trying to track it down.
Once we know what the final tab is, so to speak, what can happen next from lawmakers? What can you do?
Well, I think we can prioritize and see honestly if we need that. But you put your finger on it. First of all, we've got to know what the figures are.
California and several other states don't even supply an executive residence, let alone carrying two homes on taxpayers' tab. There are nonprofit foundations set up to raise funds for the Hawaii compound, but they bring in a fraction of the operating costs. Volunteers put in free time, too, but the rest relies on all of us to pay.
I think people are going to have to start looking more closely at where the money goes and the expenditures. I have confidence in our new governor, though. I think our governor will probably take a look at some of these things and have the ability to trim them.
I told the governor's office about the extent of the costs we could trace. The governor declined an interview, but his chief of staff said the governor will look at the options for reducing operating and maintenance costs for all state-owned property, including Washington Place and Halekia'aina. We'll check back with them to see what they find. Gina Mangieri, KHON 2 News.